afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to another exciting Propaganda Cast from your host, Imperial Dane. We're off here to a Monday Novice fight on Simwaski. Yes, indeed, the Monday Novice fight, which means less than grand players are having at it right here. In the southern corner, we are having Sergeant Smoke fighting for the Soviet Union for the glory of Comrade Stalin and the 110th Rifle Corps. Tasked with breaking through this German-held village, held by Elusive, fighting for Germany, for the Reich, for the Kampfgruppe Heinz. We got an early Kubelwagen there, by the way. Heading down here on the left, right-hand side initially. Doctrinally, we got NKVD shock rifle and guard rifle. There's an awful lot of rifle there for Sergeant Smoke versus fortification, scavenge, and special rations there for Elusive. And you can show us those shock rifle, by the way. You've also got Molotov and mine bulletins and infantry and a bit of armor there for Elusive. Kubelwagen heading over to the left side. Very bizarre opening here, by the way, from Elusive. He's not securing the viewpoint right next to his base. Setting straight to the center, probably to sort of secure, but nonetheless, I mean, ask the Ober Commander West, you want the fuel as soon as humanly possible, yet right here, Elusive seems to be considering that less of a priority there at the same time. We got here an early support weapon company, thus also delaying fuel for Sergeant Smoke, but even then, not sure what he's doing here with the truck now, moving over towards the left-hand side of the map. We got the Fulcrum, looks like moving over there to secure the fuel point. We got another Fulcrum squad down the way, got more constant, got an early Maxim as well here for Sergeant Smoke. Constant running straight into the Kubelwagen. Not entirely sure what he's intending to do with the truck all the way over there, Mr. Elusive. You got the Sturmpioniere heading towards the west as well. Might see some flanking action here, and there we go. Gaining the contact here, which I in fact pin right here though. Sergeant Smoke's ultra retreating his men. Maximus heading up to see with the Sturmpioniere. Kubag not to be moving in, but a bit too late there. Bit too late, I'm afraid. Important that he's secure. We got the Fulcrum doing nothing. Come on, Elusive, get moving. Max Schnell, forwards. Kubelwagen here trying to hold the enemy at bay. Not entirely sure what Elusive here is thinking. Got some men operating on the right flank. On the right side of the map. More conscripts arriving. Kubelwagen continuing to fall back. Truck still doing very little. And again, I'm rather wondering. I mean, what is the plan here for Elusive? Maxim here under fire from the Kubelwagen, though Kubelwagen is taking some few quick shots there back from the Maxim machine gun. Cards go checking up the left flank. Truck falling slightly back. Come on, Dieter, we can't get this truck dirty. I think it's already dirty enough as it is. I don't think a few bullet holes will make any difference. HMG crew is ready. It is safe behind this. Point there secured. Not a lot else really going on here for Sergeant Smoke. He's got a very low unit count there.
Conscripts here. The sector is at risk.
Conscripts could do with being pulled back for some reinforcement. Maxim creeping up there. Now looks like everything's being pulled over towards the left hand side, giving up the center. And all the territory there. Folks, Grenadier here coming on up half of the Maxim. We've got the Kubelwagen moving ahead again to try and deal with this machine gun menace of the Russian army. Folks, the Sturmpioniere moving up here, so now pretty much everything's going on the left hand side for Elusive. The center definitely seems a ban here, but there we go. Contra trying to flank in this case. When you change to the Sturmpioniere and the Folks, there go. Quick pulled off away from the fascist enemy. And they're outward at a better range where the assault rifles can do less. Now we've got a battle group headquarters. So basically, he sort of now decides to set up here, which rather makes the opening moves for Elusive, well, kind of pointless. I mean, there's no reason to move over here in the assault denying fuel when he could just have moved here and then just secure it that way. That would have been faster and overall more efficient, I think. Also giving him more fuel. So right there, that was quite silly, if I'm going to be generous. And overall, I mean, you generally want some kind of idea what you want to be doing early on. I mean, I'm not saying, you know, setting up here, for example, that way is bad, but overall, the way he did it, on the other hand, is bad. Otherwise, I mean, it's not a bad idea. I mean, you'll basically sort of secure a nice small frontage. You'll also cover the way to your fuel point here on this map, which is overall quite beneficial as well, making it very difficult for Sergeant Smoke to actually harass and lose a few, which is overall pretty good for a loser, but again, overall, it could have been handled better. Fox is in a bit of trouble than a lot of conscripts, so right here, I think he could easily dodge that one. Got Fox here in the building nearby as well, holding back some conscripts here. Steel and Punilla could move up a bit closer, rather than fighting from the furthest away range. We got Sergeant Smoke here pushing forward, attacking aggressively. We've got some barbed wire going up here, a bit pointless. Lastly, since of course now all the effort's being pushed over here, we got a retreat point going up there. Falsco's being pushed off there. We got conscripts falling back due to the presence of the Kuvang. The Kuvang, though, will need some repairs rapidly. Falsco's doing nothing. We got a multi. That's not a bad help. It would certainly help with some of the things here that loses up to his more defensive player around here, could certainly be to a certain extent countered by Mortar. We got Mines up in case we do see Lucifer trying to break through here, so that's not too bad, not too bad. Kuvang, though, still needs repairs. It's rather low on health, and there's certainly no point in wasting that once you've gotten it, I would say. Falsco is being suppressed by the Maxim. Mortar slowly moving up, setting up. Elusive floating here, a bit of manpower, might want to do something with it. Call in some more troops or something. Also no sign of doctrine as of yet, though so far Sergeant Smoke has not revealed his doctrine either to his opponent, so he's chosen it, but of course Elusive can't see that, and so far there's been no shock troops. I mean, once it goes there, so of course it would be pretty easy for Elusive if he paid attention. It's got a decent grasp of things to sort of figure out what Sergeant Smoke's gone for and what to expect and what to prepare for. Flanking in the combat engineers, Kuvang dealing with them on the front. Engineers that quickly need to get there. We got another truck there arriving for Elusive. Falls gonna be moving out. Quick anti-tank grenade there, and Kubelwagen kaput. Always try to cover your flanks, in particular on the Kubelwagen. One proper anti-tank grenade is, or they can easily deal with it if it's taking even just a bit of damage. Troops here a bit abandoned their own in the village center. There's a mortar going down here. And overall, we're noting here that Elusive's force are rather spread out. Overall, not really getting much of a focus or any sort of advantage here versus Sergeant Smoke, who's got a mortar supporting it, plus a mortar, which all means in most engagements, he can easily gain the advantage versus Elusive and the Germans. That's definitely a bit of a problem here for Elusive, and something he needs to rectify as quickly as humanly possible. Because overall, then this battle, if he doesn't do that, will not really go towards his advantage. Quick assault going up here. Steel Handgranate and Piotr went down there. And that was about it, really. Pioneers getting pinned down but not retreated. Oh, there we go, finally. And a Molotov forces the Falskers back there. One kill so far in the mortar. We got a Schwerer Panzer Corps going up here. Not really the wisest positioning. I mean, in theory, I can see what he's up to. I mean, he wants to cover this, but at the same time, it's a rather open position. It's also one where you can, even from here, deal with it with a field gun. Even more importantly, I mean, he's currently setting it up with absolutely no screen again, pretty much allowing his opponent to shoot at it. While it's just being set up, which only makes it easier. I mean, the only surprising thing here is that so far, Sergeant Smoke, for some reason, is not dealing with it. I mean, he's just sort of, you know, oh, look, comrade, they're setting up an anti-aircraft gun which can kill our infantry. Yes, maybe we should do something. Not really. We're on break. Let someone else do it. Also, some unit was wasted there on both sides of the field. Mostly in the German side there. More Foxes replaced them though. You're still flooding plenty of manpower again, not something you want to do, but for some reason the Elusive City seems quite keen on doing it. Fear gun here set up, but that's going to be quickly overwhelmed here by the student Pioneer if Elusive can play his cards right. Veterans one for the student Pioneer, we've got Countryman here, we've got the Spare Punch of course supporting. We got Orbital dying on the way. Storm Pioneer are not hunting down the field gun or the mortar. Oh, there we go. Bit of a mess engagement here in the village center. We got the Maximum Rage card trying to draw in the Storm Pioneer. Not bad, not bad. And there we go. Veteran here too, by the way. There we go. Field gun saved from the naughtiness of Elusive Storm Pioneer. And can now in essence just set up and begin knocking out the Schwerpanzer quarters. So right here, Elusive again has made a bit of a strategic little fumble in terms of placement of his Schwerpanzer quarters, and he's about to suffer for it. Simply put. And that's going to cost him a lot of resources and time. Of course we've got Elusive here, oh, Sergeant Smoke in the hand setting, I'm making a nice damage company. In that case you get some Katushas out or some assault guns that would certainly do quite a bit of good there, I think. Versus Sergeant Smoke. Well, I mean, Elusive and his infantry. Good lord, mixing up the two there. Falsko's attacking straight on in. Nothing to cover. They'll actually take up inside the building right in front of them. Punches straight up as well, clearly worried about any vehicles. But Falsko's doing the thing to the north here, troops reinforcing. Need to counterattack as quickly as possible. Need to keep up the pressure. And there we go. Molotov onto the building with the Folks kind of the inside it, they might want to consider getting out of there before they're burned alive. Schwerpanzer quarters almost down, Storm Pioneer is, I suppose, we're trying to repair it. There we go though, I doubt that will be very successful with the mortar and a field gun firing away there. Got another truck here. Orbs done, finally running to the battlefield, and there we go. Share up hunted quarters down. Only one orbital down unit was able to call in again. That's further going to delay any kind of taking, any kind of big rama there from Elusive. So overall, not that well handled. And overall, that should certainly give him, Sergeant Smoke here, a chance to bring in either Katusha or an SU-76 assault gun. I'd certainly recommend, I think, the Katusha in particular, if you're going to retreat towards here. Good Katusha ballast could actually wipe out a lot of infantry there. Maxim though was actually lost there, that was surprising. I mean, one thing to keep in mind, I'll just briefly pause to explain, of course, is when you get out of the building, you can actually choose what site you want them out. I mean, click here, and then sort of click on it where you actually know there's a door. In this case, that he clearly chose poorly, as he chose the one closest to the enemy. Usually you want to choose the door that your opponent can't fire at. I mean, in these kinds of cases, there's always a nice rule of thumb you must consider. If this was real life, which door would I choose? The one getting shot at or the one not getting shot at? Same with cover. Would I want to be on the side where the cover protects me from the bullets or where I protect the cover from the bullets? Those kinds of things can give you a small edge, I think, in firefights. So that's a little tip there for the newer players. Falsko's got their way to secure the Maxim. Orbs down the falling way there with the lightest machine gun 34, cutting down the rations. And looks like the Fox was there, we were able to escape with the Maxim, but right there the church simply get pelted with fangibles of fiery doom. Lighting it on fire, possibly. There's at least one building there going down in flames. Maxim though is ready to fight against the Russians now, and there we go, Kansky charging straight into it. Bit unfortunate for them there. Another truck moving up there for Elusive. Nothing happening in the mechanized armor company here. Come on, Sergeant Smoke, you build it, use it. I mean, don't build something and then not use it, in particular when you got some infantry again. You could easily kill with a good, well-placed Katusha rocket. Up the tailpipe. There go another head-on assault. Very little attempt in maneuvering out, for example, take back some of the territory over here. I mean, he's not really holding most of the territory at the moment. Got some smoke going down there, I think, from Sergeant Smoke to escape. He actually got some shock troopers out, which really should tell Elusive what he's facing off against, which is shock rifle. Structures begin to clear out. We've got grenades going in the conscripts, killing Dimitri, Vasily, and Boris. Got the maximum there firing down, bang down, but the shock troops suppressing them. Well, Stu and Pioneer here under cover of the Volksgrips moving forward. So, the Volksgrips fell back. But the combat engineers are clearly here outgunned. And there we go, getting cut down rather viciously. Even got the Orbs gun joining in there. A few extra good shots. And then straight into the shock troopers. Rather risky here for either side. Ultimately, the Orbital sort of Gun pushed off. I mean, had he, say, gone for special operations, he could have gained the Storm Gewehrs, in which case he might have had the advantage there, but he didn't. So, fun fact, still almost 20 minutes into the game, Illusive has yet to choose a doctrine. Not really good. Another spare punch headquarters a bit further back, but still in a rather well exposed position. Seems like he's learned, well, not an awful lot from the last time. And of course, now that's about 160 fuel spent on just spare punch headquarters. Although, in that regard, he's very much behind in the tech race, so interesting enough, Sergeant Smoke again. He has got the mechanized armor company up, but he's bloody well not using it. I mean, again, you know, Duke built something and they're not using it. That's waste of resources. You're not in the American army. This is a Soviet. Comrade Stalin hates waste. Squad standing by.
Fresh conscripts have arrived. Enemy forces capturing supply sector.
Occupied. The command vehicle has converted to a static building.
Getting more orbital data. Alright. Taking back some of the village. Good, good. Finally getting a bit of a move on there. Took him long enough. Elusive much, but Elusive is not one of them. More like obtuse. But, anyways, Sharks was here transferring to the student Pioneer. Under fire deck, half the unit lost. Orbital gun then having to take over the job. We got smoke grenades down. Not bad there, by the way. Forced the orbital gun to get closer. Then in this case, seems like Elusive's fought ahead and actually popped down his smoke zone, which is slightly more unpleasant. Straight into this. Forced the shock troops to run off, and this was some rather nasty chemicals. In fact, it could was in fact also used to actually force vehicle crews out of their tanks because, well, it wasn't really pleasant inside there either. So, little fun fact that. Setting up some defensive position. Not bad, though. He might have wanted to prepare for the enemy attacking from there, also from here. Molotov's going down. Sergeant Smoke does seem to be a bit sharp in that department. Taking back some territory there. Still, good, good. Orbs done. Could try and deal with what's up here instead of, you know, waiting behind the hedge or the haystacks. Sergeant Smoke still doing bugger all here with it. Looks like he's now aiming for an IS-2, but he could easily have a Katyusha, I think, up sooner, which would have speed up the process and, process and also, you know, kill some fascists in the process. But now his eyes seem rather set there on the IS-2. The Josef Stalin 2. Oh, and again caught again by the shock troopers. Still no doctrine, by the way, here from Elusive. Still no doctrine. Time for the mid-game analysis. We've got, I think, ooh, some mines went off there, but overall, in terms of territory, Elusive is kind of getting slightly back into things, but overall, he's contained here by Sergeant Smoke, who's always had a nice chunk of the map for a longer period of time. Force-wise, things are pretty much equal. Of course, he's soon going to be calling in heavy tanks, and even then, he can call in Katyushas, assault guns, and tank destroyers to support his IS-2s in whatever manner he finds, well, fitting. He's also got a nice position. Of course, again, we got Schwerpanzer quarter here rather exposed as well, which is only going to make things easier for Sergeant Smoke to deal with them. Also, more importantly, he doesn't actually cover anything seriously vital, except this point, but at the same time, because there's no victory points, any sort of serious resource points, so it's not really good, well-placed for Airpunch headquarters either. Infantry-wise, I mean, Elusive's got a chance here, but at the same time, the way he's using infantry so far is not really sort of good. He's rather well, a bit of a lame duck. He doesn't use his full force, or if he does, it's more like, you know, just throwing him at the enemy and seeing what, you know, kills the enemy. No real serious tactics or anything most of the time. There's definitely some room for improvement there for Elusive. Right now, though, I mean, he should be aware what he's going up, and he should be saving up for a Panther. It's going to take him some time again due to the fact he lost one spare punt at quarters. So it's going to take as much territory. He should probably try and see if he can't steal his opponent's fuel point away as well. Try to speed up things that way on top of everything. In the meanwhile, though, the Kedan efforts will be necessary alongside the Panther Strikes. You need to prepare for a serious armored assault. As for Sergeant Smoke, get in the IS-2 and then consider supporting it with a Katusha to help deal with infantry, but also any anti-tank weapons of the more static kind here, that way clearing up things for his armor. That would be a good move there, I think, for Sergeant Smoke. Otherwise, keep up some pressure, deal with the flankers there, and otherwise try to take back some territory there as well. That would certainly be some good moves, and otherwise clear up the Schwer Panzer quarters, that way deny an opportunity there for the Panther to arrive for Elusive, which is definitely what he wants to do, and should want to do. So let us head back to the fight here. And right here, Elusive makes another massive strategic blunder. He's almost 20 minutes into the game, and he decides to get a look. This is not really the timing for it. Again, Yorkshire at this point figure out that he's probably going to hit with something big. He's getting a look. The looks will not help with that one bit. Nice smoke. There we go. Incendiar Tiller going down the Spear Punch quarter star. That's a bit of a waste of resources from Sergeant Smoke. That's not exactly going to have a huge effect, except slightly ruining Sergeant Schultz's sauerkraut, which he was cooking for dinner. Verdammte Russen! Mein Sauerkraut! I'll have your heads for this! Meanwhile, we got the Lux there arriving. And there you go, the IS-2, the Josef Stalin, supported by a field gun. That's where our punted quarters will not last long. More setting up as well. Send orders. Enemy flank. Orbital Darden. Not sure why they're attacking the IS-2 here. Looks like they're going to try and clear out the field gun at the same time they're conducting assault across open ground in front of an IS-2. That's usually what you describe as suicide. Costco's doing what they can. They've got the Kenmare for that's probably going to do a bit more better work there for the Germans. So far, though, no shots have penetrated from either rocket launcher. I think actually the spare punted quarter got more shots going through there, the IS-2, than anything, which is a bit unfortunate. Looks like clearing up the infantry on the right flank, though. That's something there for Elusive. And a conscript squad there, rather harshly wiped out. Field gun setting up somewhere else. And there we go, got off it on the field. It looks interesting enough, he's not trying to sort of knock up the spare parts of quarters fully here. Very close to getting in the looks, but I think the looks will be able to escape here for the time being. Field gun almost knocked out. Also, the IS-2 did suffer some damage, looks like he's waiting for some repairs, so he should consider getting out some more engineers to help speed up the repairs. I mean, the faster you can get a tank into the fight, the better, in particular when it is a heavy tank. Usually when it comes to something like an IS-2, I suggest about 3 engineer units. That is the general sort of rule of thumb when it comes to heavy armor, anyways. If you were to ask me. Further heavy fire there. Conscripts routing, filters moving up. Straight into line of fire, they have the IS-2. Suffering some losses there in the process. Filters taking heavy losses, spare parts at quarters. Starving another tip there to try and clear out the Maxim, which he really hasn't moved at all since then. And it forces a Molotov. So to force him to do anything with it, not really well done there either by Elusive. And nor did he actually try to secure the rest of the map here. Tisk. Tisk! Got a KV-8 joining in the fun. turning out like Ken Murphy. I tuning with the Stu Pioneer repairing the spare parts headquarters. While folks will see it, Crouch gonna be dealing with the Oberstein, the one unit's already taking a heavy series of losses thanks to the Oberstein and the light machine gun. Might suffer the loss of the entire unit. He should move. There we go. Molotov on the opposite down, forcing them away. Almost got the Schwer Panzer Corps seems more right now with the Fuchs up north there with their Panzer Schreck, the Kitten Panzer Buchsen. Almost got the Schwer Panzer Corps. There we go. Burn to a crisp. Still nothing from the mechanized armor company here though. Still absolutely nothing. Sturm Pioniere have lost as well. Further losses there for Elusive and his German force. Just going to speed this up since basically no site would be encountering any, well, fighting versus each other. Fresh Sturm Pioniere, fresh Volksgrenadiere. Bit of lighter mortar fire there. Closing in on Veteran 3, but surprisingly few kills. More sandbags, at least he's got something going there. Assault on this position, a bit more risky than particularly in the veterans, the conscripts and the fact there's very sort of lacking in serious cover there. That will definitely give the forces the advantage, or the conscripts the advantage. There we go, actually on the right hand side again. Rather sluggish when it comes to securing additional territory there, if anything, and mine went off there, causing heavy engine damage on the truck. Exactly looking good there. And we've got a smoke screen going down. That's actually interesting to see. Not bad, not bad. It's commendable, though he doesn't really seem to do much with it. Actually seems to be laying down another one. Looks like he's got some plan in mind. Might be he's launching a flank assault. In this case, the Maxim will be able to stop it. Considering he's launching a blob assault, more or less. Oh, there he goes, switching part of it away anyways. Maxim on its own there, bit too easy to outmaneuver it, and there we go, assault going in through the smoke. Though there's nothing really on the other end of the smoke technique there to deal with it, but of course he was taking no chances out of the way. Not bad, I suppose. Maxim getting molotoved, which is going to force a retreat right back there, which is going to get it killed. Unless, of course, he does reach, he didn't just get it burned to death. Now the rest of his infantry is getting burned alive there as well. Volkswagen's flanking in there, both Orbsign units wiped out. Still no doctrine, by the way, still no doctrine. And of course, he's still got the retreat point up, so any troops here trying to retreat away only gets close and gets killed. Looks like we've now got special operations after 26 minutes. He chooses this doctrine not to help his other infantry, which could have benefited from these ability upgrades, but merely to get a command panther. My god. His active means managed to gain back the maps, I suppose that's something. That's about it, really. Looks under the command here with the Fearless Panther. Still nothing from the mechanized armor company. Again, bringing up the question why did Sergeant Smoke bother with it in the first place. Speeding this up again. Yeah, he's been a lot more chair secure, but both placing a bit passive there. Bit of lighter skirmishing there, looks like he needs to be careful. There we go, take some shots, but Ken have secured as well now by Sergeant Smoke. Another smoke screen going down, he's actually now preparing his assaults. That's actually not bad, which is certainly allowed him to get closer with his tanks, thus negating many of the German advantages, which are armor and range penetration there. Of course, in that regard, that's actually pretty well executed there by Sergeant Smoke in that regard. That is one commendable thing, actually, there for Sergeant Smoke. That's about it, sort of, really, on a large scale. Looks here needs to get away, but for some reason it's been left abandoned inside the village. There we go, wrecked. Rather waste their field by Elusive. Well, one of them he wastes. IS-2 there, opening up, interesting enough, the Panther's not trying to deal with the IS-2, instead focusing on the KV-8. field gun moving up. And he sets up a battle group headquarters right next to here. Even as the enemy armor is approaching rapidly. Really can't help but feel that elusive seems to have an elusive sense of the battlefield. He's barely got any units left as well. Getting more folks gun these, I have to rather question what they're going to be able to do with an IS-2 and a KV-8. Also looks like Sergeant Smoke is getting more engineers to replace and repair. Good, good. Another smoke grenade there. Got the Druska, by the way, on the IS-2. Grenades again. IS-2's now beginning to take some damage. Need to pull back for repairs. The KV-8 could be trying to deal with the infantry. There you go, field gun fire and our Kedmef setting up there. IS-2 getting off shot as well. Most of the shots are getting bounced out by the Panther, and the Foxes get wiped and dropping a Panzer Schreck for Sergeant Smoke to use. That's just bad news here for Deutschland. Another smoke grenade, more mortar fire. I mean, he's certainly living up to his name. I mean, that's something. Got artillery flares going down here. Not entirely sure what he's calling them now. Look, Yuri, the Germans are giving us a light show. Just more folks kind of this, I rather feel like Elusive is in a bit of illusion right now. Panther means a quick kill, we got Maxim firing back. Field gun firing. Another smoke screen here, in which case also largely negating the Panther's ability to fire from a safe position, forcing either to get close or get back. So in that regard, it's overall not actually bad smoke usage all here by Sergeant Smoke, actually. There you go again, smoke again. Making quite good use of it to deny his opponent use of his, well, armor. Effectively severing the rest of the units. Pretty solid stuff there. Very rare, actually. I don't think I've seen any higher rank players use smoke like that. So, I mean, that's easily commendable. Easily. There we go. Panther in dire straits, and there we go. Game over. Elusive giving up the fight, and there we go. I mean, in this battle, there was a lot of things. I mean, in terms of strategy, Elusive had a lot of problems. Also, in terms of placement of his trucks, there were problems. They were way too easily exposed, and thus easily dealt with from a safe distance by Sergeant Smoke. Infantry-wise, he was also a bit unimaginative, and several times he just said about doing nothing. He at least, I think, secured a lot more of the territory. Also, mines can benefit, and of course, the lack of a doctrine until very late in the game was clearly also a great mistake as well there for losers. There were plenty of points there for him to improve upon. For Sergeant Smoke, again, there's no real reason to get a mech and armor company if you're there not using. You easily have benefited from a Katyusha. So that's definitely something that could have been, I think, benefited upon as well. He could also have been a bit more aggressive, sort of trying to harass back on the right flank. A few more mines, I think, would have benefited him overall. And overall, some cashes and other bits. But overall, I like to see his use of smoke. I mean, that's nice. That's great. So, I mean, a thumbs up there. But overall, not so much else to sort of really comment upon. But hopefully you've learned something from this Monday novice fight guns, Matthias from matches, how not to play the game. And maybe some ideas on how to use smoke. Remember, smoke can make a bit of a difference as well if you use it properly. So anyways, thank you all for watching. Hope you had some fun. Hope you learned some things. If you did, why not subscribe? Tell your friends. Share it with everyone. If not, you know, send in a replay and provide some feedback in the comment section. This is Imperial Danger. Cheers and thank you all for watching. Bye.